The next presenter will be Panini Filippo from Torino Politecnico, Politecnico University, with the topic of application of A algorithm for tortuosity and effective porosity estimation of 2D rock images.
Good afternoon. So, in this presentation, I'm going to talk about the application of a star algorithm for tortuosity and effective porosity estimation of two D rock images. So, after a brief introduction, I'm going to explain the concept of tortuosity and effective porosity, and then how the geometric and hydraulic path calculation in porous media can be used for post-structure characterization. Then I'll show you an application of this methodology to a 2D image of Barea sandstone, and finally some results in conclusion. So the fluid flow at the reservoir scale can be better understood studying pore scale phenomena. In fact, porosity and permeability are dependent from the pore geometry. And for this reason, our goal is to use pore scale and pore geometry information to estimate the permeability. So the fundamental equation for the fluid flow in porous media is the Darcy's law, which relates the filtration velocity to the pressure gradient through the permeability of the medium. And the Cosini-Karman equation expresses the permeability as a rela in relation with the pore structure. And it is a function of the porosity, the hydraulic radius, RH, and the tortuosity tau. Another fundamental parameter is called effective porosity, and we'll see later how to use the effective porosity to modify the Cosini-Karman equation. So in this study, we want to focus on a methodology to estimate the tortuosity and the effective porosity. The effective porosity is defined as the volume of the pore space interested by the fluid flow divided by the total volume. And it differs from the total porosity because it does not take into account the dead-end pores, as they were represented in this picture, and the occluded pores. The tortuosity describes the sinuosity of the pore space and generally is defined as the ratio of the actual fluid path, in this picture called LE, the length of the sample in the flow direction, L. In porous media, generally two definitions of tortuosity are used. The first is the geometrical tortuosity, which is the length of the shortest path between an inlet and an outlet, divided by the length of the porous material. So here it is important to keep in mind that we need to estimate the shortest path. The other is the hydraulic tortuosity, which is the length of the actual fluid path inside the porous medium between an inlet and an outlet. So it takes into account, we need to know the velocity field inside the porous material. So by definition, the geometrical tortuosity is always lower than the hydraulic tortuosity. And here we calculate both the geometrical and hydraulic tortuosity, and then we compare them. So for the geometrical path calculation, we used a pathfinding algorithm called ASTAR. And in this picture is represented a schematics of basically this algorithm works. So we consider a generic node N along the path. And then a window of 8 surrounding cells is formed around the node N. Then we need to calculate the cost of of each surrounding node, a cost that takes into account the distance of each node to the target point. Then the node with the minimum cost is selected, and the window moves to the node for new calculations. So starting from the inlet point, this procedure is repeated until the outlet point is reached. And by this procedure, we can estimate the shortest path between two points with the obstacles, in presence of obstacles. For the hydraulic path calculation, we used our numerical simulator based on the Lattice-Boltzmann method. And as can be seen from this picture, the simulation domain is only the fluid space, and the interface between the fluid and the solid are modeled with no slip boundary conditions, and constant pressure boundary conditions are applied and at the inlet and at the outlet. In the Lattice-Boltzmann terminology, the cell is called lattice, and a further discretization is taken inside the lattice. In fact, all the particles that move with random velocity action, generally, in this case, in this method, are discretized in groups of particles with a fixed velocity direction. So for this example, which is in two dimensions, the scheme is called 2DQ9, and we have nine groups of particles, and to each group of particles is assigned a velocity direction. Then we need to calculate the density distribution function F, and when we know the density distribution function, we can recover the fluid density, the pressure, and velocity. So the final output of the simulation is the fluid density or pressure and the velocity of the fluid. Okay, now that we know how to calculate the geometrical path in the hydraulic path, we calculated the geometrical tortuosity as the average of the length of the shortest path divided by the direction, or by the length in the flow direction. And the hydraulic tortuosity is calculated as the average of the magnitude velocity of the fluid inside the porous medium divided by the velocity of the component in the flow direction. And then by the application of the pathfinding algorithm, we can estimate the pore size as the distance from the path to the wall. And we can calculate the effective porosity as the ratio between the number of the cells which belong to the portion of the pore channels crossed by a pathway and the total number of cells in the image. This is important because calculating the effective porosity in this way, we don't need this is based only on a geometrical analysis, which as we'll see is less time consuming than a numerical simulation based on the Lattice-Boltzmann method. Just by comparison, we also calculated the effective porosity based on hydrodynamic simulation, setting a threshold on the velocity field, which is equal to 1/10 of the average velocity. This is a qualitative threshold, but we believe that under 1/10 of the average velocity, the fluid can be considered not movable. Finally, we estimate the permeability. So, using the geometrical approach, we take the Koseni-Karman equation and we substitute the porosity with the effective porosity. So we take into account only the pore space which is interested by the fluid flow. And we use the definition of geometrical tortuosity for the tortuosity. And then we also calculated from the hydrodynamic simulation the permeability and directly using the Darcy's law, and where the U, the velocity, is calculated from Lax-Boltzmann simulation. Now, this is an application of this methodology for characterization, for structure characterization. So we applied this methodology to a 2D image of the Berea sandstone. And the porosity is directly calculated from the binary image. And for what regards the hydrodynamic simulation, we increased the number of cells with respect to the initial number of pixels of the image, because we need to guarantee at least four lattices in the smallest pore throat. Then the fluid is a water at reservoir conditions. And the Reynolds number is much lower than one, so we are in laminar flow and the Darcy's law can be used. Now, in this slide, there are the results of the numerical simulation with the Lattice-Boltzmann method in terms of velocity field. And the results of the pathfinding approach, where you can see the geometrical path in red between each couple of inlet and outlet. The pathfinding approach individuates the principal flow path obtained from the hydrodynamic simulation. And the two methods differ only in case of a very narrow pore throat, because in that case the fluid prefers to flow in a wider pathway. And on the other side, the ASTAR algorithm does not care how narrow is the pore throat. If it is along the shortest path, you just select to go in that direction. In these slides, I reported the results in terms of pore radius. So first of all, we calculated the hydraulic radius as the ratio between the pore area and the wetted perimeter. And then we compared this result with the mode of the distribution of the pore radius. The two results are comparable. So we can say that the hydraulic radius is a good estimate of the average pore dimension, of the pore dimension. Also from the pore radius distribution, it's possible to know what the smallest pore size is. In these pictures is represented the variation of the pore radius along a single path. And this information also is important because from this graph we can see if there are heterogeneities along the path. Here, on the left, I reported the zones interested by the fluid calculated with the geometrical approach. And on the right, with the hydrodynamical approach. The two results, also in this case, are similar. And we use these zones, which are colored by red, for the calculation of the effective porosity. Finally, in this table, I reported the numerical results. So the tortuosity was calculated both along the two flow direction and the permeability as well. And we can see that the tortuosity values calculated with the two approaches are comparable. And as expected, the geometrical tortuosity is lower than the hydrodynamic tortuosity. also for what regards the permeability, the values of the two approaches are close. So finally, we can conclude that we adopted a geometrical analysis based on the STAR algorithm for the characterization of the post-structure of an image of a 2D image of rock. And the methodology was validated against a numerical simulation based on the Lattice-Boltzmann method. And the computational time for the pathfinding approach is about 1/3 of the Lattice-Boltzmann simulation. And the results show that the pathfinding approach can give reasonable estimates of tortuosity, effective porosity, and permeability. And moreover, from the geometrical analysis, we know the pore size distribution and the minimum pore size and the pore size variation along a single path. Thank you.
Thank you, Filippo. We have 5 minutes for discussion.
Can I start?
Yes.
So thank you for the very interesting presentation. I have 2 questions, actually. The first one, have you tried to apply the approach, the overall approach for 3D images? The second one, have you compared the approaches for calculating the effective porosity and tortuosity with what is present in the image processing software like Fiji, ImageJ, or the more kind of advanced one, probably not advanced, but not a free software, which is Aviso and its derivatives.
Okay, thank you for the question. Okay, yeah, we are working on the 3D case. I didn't discuss here, but now we are working on the development of this methodology to 3D images. So yes, we are working on that. And for what regards the second question, no, I didn't. You mean for the calculation of porosity?
For the porosity and tortuosity.
Tortuosity. No, we didn't. We didn't compare the result with those softwares.
It would be interesting actually to have this benchmark because many people from oil industry nowadays accept the Aviso.
Aviso software.
The ImageJ, the GeoDict, and others like a benchmark kind of tools for getting the information about the 2D and 3D images and putting this information as an input for some models predicting the transport properties.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I see the hand from Nikolai Smirnov, please.
Thank you, Filippo. Can you show just the results, the table with the results? Yes, this slide, because it was so fast, I didn't. So here I can see that just using geometrical hydrodynamic simulation, well, we have just the tortuosity for hydrodynamic simulations. It is higher than for geometrical, and so it is higher in y direction than in x direction. And then we come to permeability, and as far as I remember, Karman-Kazeny formula, tortuosity stands there in the denominator in the second power, if I'm right.
Yes.
And so that means that I was expecting that if geometrical hydrodynamic tortuosity, for example, in X direction is higher than geometrical, then permeability should appear to be lower. But here I see that it's practically twice higher as well in hydrodynamics simulations. And then if we come to along the Y axis, then it is still higher for hydrodynamic simulations, but well, a little bit less, despite tortuosity, is practically similar. So please comment a little bit these results.
Okay, because, okay, the yes, the the geometrical tortuosity is calculated, okay, is based on, yes, we have the tortuosity at the second power and the denominator, but we still have the effective porosity on the numerator.
But effective porosity is practically the same for both cases. It is the center line. So that's why it's strange to have in case...
I mean, okay, you are comparing the geometrical tortuosity. So so the geometrical tortuosity with the hydrodynamic. With the hydrodynamic tortuosity.
Yes, the hydrodynamic tortuosity is higher. Effective porosity is practically the same, a little bit lower for hydrodynamic. So even lower for...
No, because, okay, I understand the question.
There, just ratio turns to be, with some other coefficients, turns to be much higher.
So no, because here the hydrodynamic permeability is not calculated with the Kozani-Karman. It's calculated from the Darcy's law. It's calculated this formula. That,
but there still exists Kozani-Karman formula. And looking at it, at this formula, and comparing it with the calculations, well, I have some, confusion. Confusion of the results. So I cannot understand, I can't explain myself if the reason for these just numbers. Each one separately, well, it is acceptable, but taken as a whole table, that shows some internal contradictions. Well, probably it's necessary to analyze. Of course, I understand that it's difficult to answer on spot this question, but I think it is worth just analyzing this effect in more details.
So you think that
colleagues, excuse me, maybe we can we need to stop our discussion because we have time. I see the hand from Dario. Maybe Dario can say some words about these results. Dario, can you say really short?
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Hey, good afternoon. Just a very quick comment. Just I had a comment to what Filippo was saying. The two approaches are different, okay? Even if in the table we are comparing the tortuosity in X and Y direction and the effective porosity, the two permeability are calculated with two totally different approaches. So the geometrical, the permeability indicated in the column geometrical refer to the pure Kozani-Karman equation would take into account of the geometrical tortuosity, the effective porosity calculated through the geometrical approach, okay, which is only based on the static, on the analysis of the geometry of the system, whereas the permeability in X and Y direction calculated through Lattice-Boltzmann simulation is based on the typical calculation of permeability in which you assume that the system is like a continuum, and therefore you have delta P and the rate and the average flow velocity of the system. So they are different for sure. And this is the reason why we have here a comparison. But in any case, we are available for further discussion. Yeah.
Thank you for your comment, Dario.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Filippo, for your presentation.
Thank you.